Now, in the meantime, the interim government just issued a press release a few minutes ago pertaining to the assassination today of the American missionary in Bambui, in the neighborhood there in Bamenda. And while we are waiting for others to join the broadcast, I'd like to read to you the press release that we just published a few minutes ago. And this release is, of course, signed by me, yours truly, and it reads, "The interim government of Ambazonia condemned vehemently the brutal gun-gun execution of Charles Truman, Chesco, an American missionary in Bambui, a small town in Mezan County, in the northern zone, by French Cameroon soldiers on this day, October 30, 2018. The interim government has been reliably informed that Mr. Truman, a humanitarian and missionary worker of United States origin, was shot dead while in his car for unclear reasons. The gun-gun execution of Mr. Truman reinforces the fact that the genocide in Ambazonia is real and a testimony to the carnage Mr. Kobe and his regime continue to unleash on our territory and, of course, on our people and innocent bystanders. We have learned that the driver of the vehicle in which Mr. Truman was being transported is nowhere to be found. He may have been also killed or picked up by the French Cameroon assassins to cover evidence." Again, I'm reading to you a press release that we just sent out from the interim government in respect to the assassination today of the American missionary in Bangui, in the northern zone. And the release continues, "We have reminded the U.S. government that soldiers of French Cameroon," I don't think that again, "we have reminded the U.S. government, we remind the U.S. government that soldiers of French Republic of Cameroon have no value for human life, and that their citizen has been executed in the same way that Ambazonians are being killed on a daily basis. Soldiers from French Cameroon have earlier killed a priest, Reverend Father So, and a Ghanaian pastor, Ato, under similar circumstances as that of today. The interim government of Ambazonia is appealing to the United States government to take action now and stop Mr. Pierre and his brutal army from completing a genocide by favoring this conflict at the United Nations Security Council. We remind Mr. Pierre and his military junta that they shall face the International Criminal Court for the gruesome atrocities being committed against the peaceful people of the Southern Cameroon and Ambazonia." Again, the press release continues, We call on Ambazonians to remain vigilant and avoid Cameroon's military, whose only mission in our territory is to exterminate us while they continue to defend ourselves. We call on Southern Cameroonians in the United States and other countries to light candles this evening today to mourn the great American who sacrificed his life for coming to serve as a missionary to Ambazonia. And lastly, we express our heartfelt condolences to the United States Embassy in the capital of French Cameroon, Yaounde, and to the family of Mr. Truman. And we pledge to provide the United States government and embassy with our support and they investigate this gruesome assassination. That is the end of the press release. Again, I was reading to you the press release that we just sent out from the Communications Department in respect to the assassination today in Bamenda of missionary Truman, killed by French Cameroon soldiers. And we have also gathered that the driver of the van, or the driver of the vehicle, who was driving the missionary, has not been seen. He may have been taken away, or killed, been taken away by French Cameroon soldiers to cover the events. We are still doing further investigation to get the details as to how the Roman priest died. But again, that is the message, that is the information. We are appealing to all Ambazonians in the diaspora, light a candle today in appreciation to honor Reverend Truman, who died, who went to Cameroon. In fact, we understand that Reverend Truman has only been in Cameroon for 2 weeks. 2 weeks. And they killed him at gunpoint. Why do you go shooting a vehicle that is not a threat to you? We know that this killing finally wakes up the Americans, who think that Ambazonians can sit still and have their people assassinated in the same manner with impunity. However, again, I appeal to every one of you Ambazonians in the diaspora, live in Canada today, let's honor this brave missionary who died working for you, working for your family, working in our territory. Let's honor him, please. Thank you.